Have a little peek.
Oh, okay.
So it's not me serving jail time, is you? How are you doing, Annabelle?
I'm good, thanks.
Did you love it? What are you giggling for? You're only here to play a little game.
Nervous.
Yeah, don't panic. I'm only going to take a little bit of money off of you, all right? Just a little. Now, this is a bit of a passion sort of project for me because I've got a little bit of an obsession with sort of finding out old con games
okay.
and like collecting them. I love them. Like, all the ones from all the years gone by, I just like to find out how they work. And my favourite one that I found just now, and I carry it with me everywhere, is from the 1920s. I think the reason I like it so much is because at the time, gambling really shouldn't have been happening. It was all outlawed along with bars and booze and all that kind of stuff during the Prohibition. We know that there was bars and speakeasies and that kind of thing. They had to be there. And that's primarily where this game was played. And I think that's why I like it, because they found a way around the law. Not only did they find a way to still con people out of their money, which is always a bit of a swindly kind of thing to do, but they also found a way so they wouldn't get put in jail for it. And the little loophole they had found was on the shape of the card. The law mentioned the shape of the card and not the game.
Okay.
So it meant if they had a different shape of card, they could actually play a game quite easy and not go to jail. So what the con men figured out was this. Where the hell is it? There we go. What they figured out was this. They could just carry like one or two cards. If it was a full card, I'd be stuffed. I'd still go to jail. However, all they'd done was just get two of them, tear them in half, and then get away with this legally, all right? Mm-hmm. So the game is very simple. They would put one card away in their pocket, in our case the queen, and ask you what one was there. Now at this point it's easy because you can see the two there. Now if I dug this one back out though, and left it face down, it would be harder for you to follow that queen. I'll do it the slow way for you, all right? As slow as I possibly can for you. Now if I start to mix them like that, don't follow the two, you've actually got to follow the queen, okay? In fact, one more time. So if I put that in my pocket just like that, mm-hmm. where's the queen?
In your pocket.
Are you sure? Keep in mind it's 20 bucks you're going to lose when you don't get it right.
Right.
Okay. Here, I'll go a little bit slower for you. Now again, it's not the two you've got to follow, it's the queen underneath. Let me grab that and I'll just...
Yeah.
All right, so where's the queen?
I want to say in your pocket.
Right, now here's the point. I need to get you on board to keep spending money. So at that point, I'd let you win that one a little bit, all right?
Okay.
Now, I don't want to do that too much, though, because it means you'll get all my money off of me. But what I would do is let you know that they used to mark cards as well to follow them easier. So what I'm going to do, grab that pen for me, and I'll hold this up just like a little table like that. Can you pop your name on there for me? Perfect. Kind of hard to see within the queen, but it means it's easier on me, I guess. Now, again, here's the game. I went a little bit quick on that one because, again, it's signed. You can see exactly where it is, and I don't want you catching up on me, all right? Where would you say the queen is?
In your pocket.
Sorry, my dear. I'll make it even easier on you. Write your name on that as well. Now, this is the point where my accomplice, my associate, would kind of come around and say, look, the police are around, so you kind of want to wrap this up quick. And what I would do at that point is have you put your hand out, and this is where I would bet the big bucks. Put your other hand on top. Now, right over top, I'm going to try and sneak maybe one, maybe two. Try and make it so you can't see what one I get.
Okay.
Right? So you don't know if you've got one card there. You don't know if you've got two of the halves on there. You don't know if it's the queen. You don't know if it's the two. Now, at this point, my body would come around and tap me on the back and say the cops are coming.
Mm-hmm.
And at that point, I would just pick up all the money you've got there and put it in my pocket. And I would say, not me, officer. Like, she's the one trying to gamble with me. Like, she's trying to get my money off of me. I mean, I don't have too much to take, but she's trying to get it off me. You could protest a little and say that I'm the bad guy, but I'm not the one holding a full card. Now, I know you're thinking you're not holding a full card either, but I'd be a bit sneaky and just do that, just to make sure you go to jail. Have a little peek.
Oh, okay.
So it's not me serving jail time, is you? I do apologise, but hey, I've got to go and earn more money.
The both the ones that I signed?
Yep.
No.
Thank you, Kayla, my dear.
Yeah.